Hi friends, I hope all of you are well and doing your work at home. So for today, I am here to discuss about one topic. My dear, can you tell me? So far you are at home, that's why you are listening all commands and all orders of your parents or not. I hope you are obeying them and you are respecting them also. Otherwise, you are trying to fulfill their all wishes and desires. So to know about that matter, are you doing or not? That's the question in my mind. So but to know and to discuss about the fact today, I'm here to discuss one story with you. Okay? So are you ready to know and to learn about the story? Do you know what the name of the story? The name of the story is An Ideal Child. So far in case of Treasure of Valuable Books and Sundar Project. Okay? So but get ready fast and we are going to know about one matter. About whom? About Shravan Kumar. Okay? He is the guy who is really outstanding and imaginary matter in case of the story, also in its character. When you will go through the story, obviously we will know and we will read and learn about the matter. And so far, let's discuss about the topic at first. And ideal means perfect. Who is perfect, and we can say that from all sides, all round, we can say that he is totally correct. And that's why we are talking about perfect child, okay? And then also one thing I want to include with that one, we know that Treasure of Valuable is a story book, and also in present case also it is a short story. What is short story? Already I said last class that short story is a piece of prose fiction and which contains few characters and few scenes are there, and after all at the end of the moment ends with a moral message. Short story is a prose fiction, and so far few incidents are there, few characters are there, and at the end of the story ends with a moral message. So in the present case also we will know there are not huge characters, few characters are there. First character on screen you are able to see Shravan Kumar, an ideal child, and second character so far Shravan's blind parents. Okay, there are few characters. So for all about Shravan and Shravan's parents. Okay, what is the moral of the story? At first we will go through the story, and after that time we will know and learn about the matter. Okay, get ready. Page number 14. Open please in your book Treasure of Valuables. So let's discuss and let's read. An ideal child, Shravan Kumar. Shravan Kumar is a great example of an ideal child. He is known as a person who had immense love and respect for his parents. Although he was born to poor and blind parents, yet he never complained. He was always thankful to God for giving him the opportunity to serve his parents. He worked hard to make his parents comfortable and happy. Every day, he listened to his blind and aging parents and attended to their needs with complete dedication and love. One day, seven parents said, "Son, we have become old and want to visit the various holy places." Shravan's parents believed that a pilgrimage in old age could satisfy their hearts and give them abundant peace of mind. It is believed that a journey undertaken in old age to various scenes and holy places purifies the soul and take one nearer to God. Therefore, Shravan's old parents who wanted to seek repentance for the sins they had committed knowingly or unknowingly in their lives and wish to go to the various holy shrines. In those days, means of transport were scarce and costly, and Shravan Kumar did not have much money. He therefore decided to place his parents into two baskets. He took a strong bamboo stick, and at its two ends, he tied two baskets with strong ropes. Shravan placed his father in one of the baskets and his mother in another one. Okay? Carrying on his shoulder this bamboo stick with a basket at each end, Shravan started on the pilgrimage. Shravan was young. After carrying the two baskets, his shoulders ached and his feet were full of blisters. Yet he continued to fulfill his parents' wishes. Although Shravan was poor, but it was his respect and love for his parents that gave him the strength to fulfill his parents' wishes. Oh my God, what a lovely story we can say. So for Shravan Kumar, you know very well, he is a child. And his parents so far were blind. In spite of that one, he never thought anything wrong in his mind. He thought that what is going on is good. And what happened was good. And what is going to be happened, and so far will good also. So for God is always good. That's why he never blamed to God for this present situation. He was poor. He had no money. He's for that one day his parents said to him that, my dear boy, we want to visit many holy places and saints because knowingly or unknowingly we are committing sins in our life. That's why we have to purify, we have to repentance. That's why we want to place, we have to visit many holy places, many temples. Also, so far at that moment, Shravan Kumar said, Shravan Kumar agreed according to their own parents' wishes. The matter is here, Shravan Kumar, he had no money, that's why he placed his parents into two baskets and he placed a bamboo stick on his shoulder. And always he traveled a lot, many different places, many holy saints. And it was not a very easy task, it was very hard and troublesome matter, and so far he got huge pain and so far acting is also shoulder. But in spite of that one, he didn't stop his journey, he continued his journey. So far that's the in an intense love and respect, and so far you can say also he's obeying his parents from his heart, from his mind. And that's one is boy about Shravan. That's what we are talking about. Shravan Kumar is an ideal child. Are you ideal? Do you listen to your parents' orders? Do you listen to your parents' comments or always their advices, their suggestions or not? Always try to listen, my dear, because parents are always in this way. They are always good. They are like God. If you do not obey their orders or anything, then we are disobeying them. We are disobeying the God also. We are committing sin. To be an ideal child, to be a good boy or good girl, always try to listen to their orders and try to fulfill their wishes and expectations. It is the most good thing in our life. And present case also, what is the moral of the story? We must take care, respect, love and obey our parents. We must take care, respect, love and obey our parents. My dear students, we are here in this world due to one reason, for them only or for nothing else. If you do not follow, if you do not listen to their words, then you don't have the value of your parents to you. So if you want to give the value to your parents, then you have to follow them, you have to respect them, you have to take care of them. Maybe any situation, maybe any time, maybe anywhere. Always try to fulfill their all wishes as far as possible. Then obviously, God will help you a lot and you will do something good. If you want to be good, then you have to follow all these tricks and rules. So that's all about the story. Okay, my dear, now we are going to discuss about the comprehension portion and summary evaluation of the story. Okay. So let's continue, my dear. We are going to discuss about the treasure of values. The lesson is an ideal child. And now today we are going to discuss about the comprehension course about how many assessment questions. Okay, have you got it? Page number 16. So just open in your book, my dear. So far we are going to discuss about all question answers. First of all, look at the page number 16. What we learn from the story. Now we'll discuss after that one. We will discuss about all question answers. First of all, what we learn. Dear friends, just now you saw how Shravan Kumar had immense respect for his parents. Respecting our parents is the most essential thing we should do in our life. Our parents will always be with us as a pillar of love and support. So my dear, we are spending a tremendous time with our parents, with your mom and dad, but if you miss someone, then obviously you will be able to get the love and so far affection for them. When you will go away, you will go far away from them, that time we can feel it. Also, you are staying at home, we are getting their love, affections and immense taking care and so far everything, all things from them. But we have to return also it to them. So that's the momentum and that's the topic. So get ready fast, my dear students. Now we are here to discuss about our questions. First of all, question number A. Why was Shravan thankful to God? Why was Shravan thankful to God? Already I have written the answer. Shravan was thankful to God for giving the opportunity to serve his parents. Shravan was thankful to God for giving the opportunity to serve his parents. Okay, my dear. Next question. How did Shravan help his parents in household work? Shravan helped his parents by serving hard work and fulfilling their wishes, needs every day. Okay. Third question. What was Shravan's parents' wish? Shravan's parents wish that in their old age they will visit various holy places. Okay. Next one. How did Shravan fulfill the wish of his parents? Shravan Kumar placed his parents into baskets and tied ropes with a bamboo stick on his shoulder and started to carry them on the pilgrimage. Okay. Number five, what does the life of Shravan Kumar teach us? The life story of Shravan Kumar teaches us we must obey and respect our parents' wishes and make them happy. Okay. So for already I said about the topic in case of our moral message. Yes or no, have you got it? So have you got all the answers, my dear? Thank you. And once again, we are looking next. Okay. Next one, B. So friends, already completed A, summary, assessment, all questions we answered. Now we are looking for T. Okay. Take the correct option in case of question number B. So for first question is, Shravan had immense respect for his teachers or parents. So for correct answer is parents. Okay. And next one, Shravan's parents were deaf or blind. Already you know very well, blind. Yes, correct. And next one, Shravan's parents wanted to visit holy saints, the world. You know, holy saints. Miss A option is correct. And next one, number four, Shravan took his parents from place to place in car or basket. Which one? Yes, correct. Basket. So far, thus we have completed also question number B. And now we are looking for complete the following sentences. Means we have to complete the sentences and so with proper information from the text. Okay. Every day, Shravan worked hard to. So from here, I have written make his parents comfortable and happy. Make his parents comfortable and happy. Okay. Next one. Shravan's parents are aging, so they wanted to visit. They wanted to visit the various holy places. Okay. They wanted to visit the various holy places. Number third, Shravan did not have much money. So he decided he will carry his parents in two baskets. He decided he will carry his parents in two baskets. Okay. Next one, number four, Shravan always listened to his blind and aging parents. Okay. So far, that's all. And already we have completed in case of number C also. Okay. And summative assessment. Now turn the page and page number 7 we are talking about formative assessment. So far there are two questions. Okay. Answer the following questions truthfully. If you see a 100 rupee note falling from a person's pocket, what would you do? Okay, first question is that one. So for my dear, this is the homework for you. And so far I have written also formative assessment is the homework for you. And you have to complete that form also. You have to write down your own feelings and emotions and share and thought. Okay, so for my dear, now I will say about the fact about myself, what I can do or what I would do. So far, if you see 100 rupees note falling from a person's pocket, that time I will say, I will inform the guy, I will inform the person. So far about the fact that, so far my dear friend, just look at already you so far it's not your fault, unconsciously your from your pocket the money has fallen. Okay, so far that's the topic and I want to draw his attention also and I will inform him about the fact so that he would get money back. Okay, and so far next one, write about an incident when you were angry at your parents. Also write why you were angry and what you did. So far I want to say one fun incident in my life also. One day I wanted to eat some chocolate. Okay, chocolate cake. That time my parents said that don't eat. Okay, they didn't give it to me and I was very angry at that moment. But when I went to school, my school teacher said to me that, you know, so far fast food or junk foods are injurious to health, don't eat all these things. That time I felt very sorry for my parents because I got angry over them. And that time I also went back to the home and when I went there and when I returned at home, that time I said to my mom and dad, I'm very sorry for my rude or bad behavior. So that's the feeling from my center, from my zone and from my mind. What do you feel? And if you have any incident, if you can remember, also you have write down according to one view. Okay, so far share with us also and I hope that you will write down honestly all these answers. Okay, thank you my dear, take care of yourself. Next day we shall meet once again here with new lessons and new topic and new ideas and new views. So till that moment, have a nice day to you.